Hello friends, today in this video I am going to explain you about the concept of OOPs, that is Object Oriented Programming Languages. In this video, as we all know, the OOPs feature, these are the four pillar of that OOPs. Okay, object-oriented programming languages, that is encapsulation, abstraction, inheritance and polymorphism. In this video we will talk about that encapsulation. Actually, what's that encapsulation? Why we use encapsulation in that OOPs language? Okay, encapsulation is the binding of data and the function inside the class, within the class, is called the encapsulation. In the layman language, we can say that through program, in our program, any variable, if we have declared that like that int ABC, and if our program is thousand or fifteen hundred lines, it's a very large program, the coding is there, then in the beginning of program we have declared that int ABC, then after thousand or 1200 lines, again we have declared that globally int ABC, and then after 1000 line once again we have declared ABC, the same variable name with that as we have previously at the beginning of the program, we have declared that. Then after 1000 lines, same variable name. Then in some programming language, it will show error, because with the same variable name, it will create a problem. So what we'll do when we will write the program. Then we will declare the variable inside the class, so that we will declare as a private. Okay, we will declare it as a private scope, as a private. Okay, because so that it will use within the class, within that class. Okay, and it will not get error in that case. OOPs will follow that encapsulation, the binding of data and data variable and function within the class is called that encapsulation. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Now in next video we will discuss about that other feature of that OOPs languages. Okay, thank you all, thank you for watching.